Hello guys and welcome to my channel. My name is Mallory Page and I'm a future dietitian that has recovered from an eating disorder, and I've gotten some requests to go over the video about Mary Kane. I was the fastest girl in America until I joined Nike. I think this is a really important topic to talk about, so I want to go over all the things you're wondering. Is this actually true? Why didn't she come out with this sooner? Is this actually a problem within athletics? And if so, what can we do about it now? As you probably know, coming out of high school, Mary Kane was the fastest girl in America, and she signed with Alberto Salazar of the Oregon Project in order to elevate her career. Instead of elevating, she ended up regressing, and she just came out with her story a few days ago about what happened. If you haven't watched that video, I highly suggest you do, but I'm just gonna jump right into the meat of this video. Is Mary Kane telling the truth? In my opinion, I 1000% believe yes. As you can see in the video in this clip,
I was the fastest girl in America.
Mary Kane, there are women here almost twice her age, being lifting her weight.
I set many national records, and I was a straight A student.
Mary Kane has an insanely perfectionist personality, a 4.0, the fastest runner in America. That only makes it so much easier for her to fall into eating disorder tendencies. She does not see Alberto telling her to lose weight as something that he's projecting onto her. She sees it as an inner problem within herself, and that is what makes it so challenging. So why did she not come out about this sooner? Well, because it's so freaking scary. Are you kidding me? Going up against Nike, going up against the most world-renowned coach for running in her sport, and let alone going through that with all the external pressures that she's going through and internal pressures as a young woman in this sport with so many expectations. We really just need to take ourselves out of the outsider perspective and put ourselves into her shoes and think about what it would be like going through this. Is this really a problem in sports though? I have now worked in sports for going on 5 years. I've worked at two large universities. I've worked for Exos, which is a huge company working with all ranges of athletes. I've also worked on the side and as a personal trainer, and I was an athlete myself, and that is where my personal eating disorder journey actually started. So let me tell you, yes, this is such a huge problem. The sad thing is this continually gets swept under the rug because there's this really hard balance between if an athlete has an eating disorder and dealing with that and wanting them to perform. Sadly, a lot of coaches do not want to investigate further because if their athlete is properly performing, they do not want to deal with those implications. A lot of coaches have no understanding of what the actual weight that their athlete needs to be at is. And you can see that with Alberto in this clip.
Alberto was constantly trying to get me to lose weight. He created an arbitrary number of 114 pounds, and he would usually weigh me in front of my teammates.
If Mary Kane was to weigh 114 pounds on the BMI calculation at a height of 5'7", which is what she is recorded online, she would have a BMI of 17.8, which at that point is already underweight. Now, you need to take into account that BMI for athletes is not even an accurate predictor. Your muscle weighs way more than fat. And as you can see with Mary Kane, she literally had no fat on her body. So at that point, in order to get to the weight of 114 pounds, she would have to lose muscle and also, therefore, decrease her performance. Yes, weight is important in athletics. But at the same time, we cannot be pushing our athletes towards unsustainable goals because they will never be able to succeed at that weight. Athletes need to find the specific weight that works best for them, and that needs to be done under supervision and also while making sure that they're not developing disordered tendencies while they are doing that. We really need to remember this because this is not just happening at the most elite level. This is happening all the way down into even high school sports. This is a systemic problem that we need to address in order for our athletes to be healthier and have a better mentality in their sport. Okay, so this is obviously a problem, but how do we fix it? This is the most important part, and Mary Kane said it best herself.
We need more women in power. Part of me wonders if I had worked with more female psychologists, nutritionists, and even coaches, where I'd be today.
We need to have a more comprehensive care team for these athletes, especially when they're at this super, super high level. Men and women have different strengths, and we don't always completely understand the needs of the other person. So we need to have both men and women on a comprehensive care team in order to give the best care to all athletes. In Mary's case, she really needed a nutritionist and a sports psychologist on board with her care. Because when Alberto would be saying those unrealistic weight goals, the nutritionist would have been able to evaluate that, look at an accurate body composition, and then give her the right nutrition prescription in order to fuel her performance best. She also would have been able to monitor disordered eating tendencies in order to make sure that we weren't promoting a worse mindset and therefore taking away from her racing. On the other hand, a sports psychologist would have been able to really help her work through this perfectionist mentality that she's dealing with and also have strategies to undergo this immense amount of pressure that she has as a young girl. Lastly, we just need our coaches to have better education. Although there are some coaches like Alberto that probably did not mean well, there are so many coaches that mean the best for their athletes, but they just don't really understand how to set realistic goals for their athletes or how to help them best take care of their mental health. We need to provide better training to our coaches so that they know how to deal with this and/or they know how to refer out. We need to make sure that our coaches are not doing things like Alberto, where they are weight shaming, weighing their athletes in front of people, or just really valuing them only for their physical attributes instead of their mental attributes as well. I think Mary Kane is a beacon of light and inspiration in this time. We needed someone to speak about this and to spread the message to athletics, not even just track, not even just females, but to all of athletics, that we need to take disordered eating and comprehensive care more seriously within all sports. We can no longer let this go by just because we want our athletes to perform. They are also people, they have emotions. Their worth is not just valued by their numbers or their performance. We need to think about this, and I'm so thankful to Mary that she brought up this subject and how brave she is in order to create this change, not just in Nike, not just in sports, but in the world and how people view athletes. Thank you so much for watching today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up because I want to spread this message as far as possible and reach as many people as we can. If you enjoyed this style of video, definitely head over to my channel because I release videos getting real about nutrition and wellness, such as topics like this. Definitely hit subscribe as well if you want to see more videos from me because that's how you'll be notified. I really hope that I see you back here soon, and I hope that you start spreading this message and increasing awareness. Maybe share this video with a friend, share it with someone that you know. Let's really get this ball moving, not only just for Mary Kane, but for all the athletes out there that could be going through this as well. Bye guys, see you back here soon.